Now let's talk about the law of sines, case 2. This is where we have two sides and an angle that's not included between them. In this case, we're going to be using the law of sines to solve for an angle. In the first case, we were using the law of sines to solve for a side length, and there was a unique solution. Well, there's a big catch to this case. We don't always have one unique solution when we're solving for an angle. We can have one, or two, or none. We're not going to get infinitely many like we sometimes get when we're solving, but we can have zero, one, or two solutions. How do we know what we have? Well, I'm going to go through an example of each. Basically, there's always a point in time where we take an inverse sine of something, and either it's going to be not possible to take the inverse sine of a quantity, so that's the none case, or there's going to be only one reasonable solution, so we'll have a unique solution to our triangle, or there will be two options that are reasonable for the angle measure, and in that case we'll have two unique triangles. Let's look at those cases. Okay, so we let little a equal 28, little b equal 15, and angle A is 110 degrees. So I've drawn a reasonable looking triangle for this case. Now, how are we going to go about solving it? Well, the points that we know, we have the combination of the angle measure A and its side, and we have the other side B, so it must be angle B that we're going to solve first. So sine of B divided by 15 is sine of 110 degrees divided by 28. So the sine of B, I'm just going to multiply by 15, sine of 110 over 28. And I'm going to get a decimal value for this. Let me go get my calculator and I'll figure that out. Okay. I suggest when you get these decimal values going out at least four decimal places, if not actually just using the entire thing. So what is B? Well, I have to take the inverse sine of both sides. So B is the inverse sine of 0.5034. I'm just going to say inverse sine of the previous answer in my calculator so it gets as accurate as possible. And I get, calculator spits out just one angle, 30.23 degrees. But there can be more than one angle because 30.23, let me just draw a line here. 30 is somewhere there-ish. If I'm on the unit circle, if I think about it that way, the sine value represented here is going to be the same as the sine value of its complement. So if I take, and there's lots of other sine values that are going to be the same, right? But in particular, the complement is going to work because it's 180 minus this guy, so it's going to be also potential for in the triangle. So B could also be 180 minus 30.23 degrees. Which is equal to 149.77. Okay, now this is the point. We have two potential routes to go. We were able to take the inverse sine, so we know that we have at least one solution. Is this a reasonable solution? Well, in a triangle that already has a 110 degree angle measure, we can't have an angle measure of approximately 150 degrees because we're going to go over the 180 limit. So this one is not possible. So that means that we have exactly one solution. And when I say one solution, I mean one solution to the entire triangle, and we haven't completed that yet. We've only found one angle, 30.23 degrees. So we have some more work to do. First, I can take 180 minus 110 minus 30.23, and this angle is 39.77. Now I still need to find little c, so we'll need a different screen for that. If I'm going to find little c, I do have to use my calculated amount. I try to avoid that if at all possible. So I'm not going to use b to go with this. I'm going to use the thing that was given to me, a and it's side 28. Again, this is just trying to keep as many errors from happening as possible. So if I had an error when I calculated B, it's going to be perpetuated here. So I'm going to use the things that are known instead. And now this is just back to what we were doing in the last video. Multiply by C on both sides and divide by this other quantity. So it's 39.77 divided by sine of 110 over 28. And I'm going to use my calculator to find that. So that's equal to 19.1. So what do we have? We have angle A was 110. Angle B, let's see, C was 39.77. Okay, if we think back, angle B was 30.23 degrees. Little a was 28, that was given. B was 15, that was given. And C is 19.1. Does this seem reasonable? Well, these add up to 180, so that's good. And 19 is in the realm of 15 and 28. I think it's something like 1200 or something. So that seems reasonable. So there's my one unique solution in this case. Okay, let's look at another example where we don't have one unique solution. Okay, if the sides and angle are given as those, then what do we know? I'm going to solve for B first because I know side length B equals the sine of 38 degrees over 42. So the sine of B equals 45 times that right-hand side. So I use my calculator. So I get sine of B is 0.6596. So B is the inverse sine of that. My calculator spits out 41.3, if you like, degrees. And then we know this could be or 180 minus 41.3. is 138.7. In this case, given that angle C is 38, either of these are options because we still have a little bit, not very much. If I add 138.7 plus 38, I get 176.7. I don't have a whole lot of room. It's a teeny tiny third angle, but I do have another option here. Okay, so let's just get a new screen a minute. So far we have two cases. In one case, we'll get to it. Angle B is 41.3. In the second case, angle B is 138.7. C was given as 38 degrees. And A is what's left over. I'll calculate that a minute. So here's our two possibilities. Either 3.3 degrees, so it's teeny tiny. Doesn't look like what my picture looked like, but that doesn't mean anything. And the other one is 100.7. So either one of those are options, and we have to give both of them. There are two solutions to this. So what do we have left? We have little a, little b, little c. B is 45, C is 42, so we need to find A in both cases. It's supposed to say 45 and 42, even though it kind of looks like a 9. Okay, so let's find A in both cases. So sine of A divided by little a, and I'm going to go back to the one that was given again because I want to make as little mistakes as possible over 42. So A is the sine of 100.7 divided by the sine of 38 divided by 42. Okay, so in this case, A is 67, according to my calculator. And then in the second case, we have sine of 3.3 over little a is the sine of 38 over 42. So A is the sine of 3.3 degrees divided by sine of 38 over 42. And according to my calculator, that is 3.93. So you might say, wait, where's my mental check here? Because this is not in the realm of 45 and 42. But remember, the angle was 3.3. So this is a teeny tiny angle. It's a pretty squished little triangle with a very small side. So that does make sense. So here we have exactly two solutions, and this is what they are. You need to give me all of this up here, all six for each triangle. And sorry, I listed that last one as example two, but it's actually example four from the notes because we were continuing on from case one. So sorry about that if that was confusing. This is example five as labeled on the case one and case two combined notes. So if you're wondering, when I started with example three, where did one and two go? Well, it's on a different video. A is 50, B is 100, and angle A is 50 degrees. So when I'm drawing these, just to let you know, I'm just estimating as best as I can. This looks like it's about 50 degrees, somewhere around a 45 degree, something like that. Just giving myself a little ballpark. 50, B is 100. So obviously I'm way off, right? Because this was supposed to be twice as long as this side. It doesn't matter at all what your picture looks like, as long as you can make sense of it. I like to draw a picture. It makes more sense to me. So what do I need? I need angle B first, divided by 100, equals the sine of A over 50. So the sine of B is 100 times the sine of 50 degrees over 50. Okay, so according to my calculator, when I punch this in, I get that the sine of B is equal to 1.53. Now, if you proceed and try to take the inverse sine of this, what's going to happen? Your calculator is going to say, invalid domain, because the sine never gets above 1. So this is not possible. What does that mean? It means there are no triangles like this. No solutions. So that's what you write, no solutions. I believe on WebAssign, it asks you to write DNE for does not exist in all capitals, just to be sure. So why did my triangle not look right? Because it's impossible to make a triangle look right because there is no such triangle. So that covers all three cases. Either there's one unique solution, or there's two, or there's none. And it's all based on what happens right here with the sine, and when we get B equal to, either it doesn't exist, or we get one angle and the other one doesn't make sense, or we get two that can make sense.